What's up, y'all? Welcome back to my channel, Solana Coke. If you didn't know, today I got a brand new story time for you. Yes, honey, get into it.
Get into it, yeah.
Today I got a brand new story time for you, and I got like a chit chat. Get ready with me. Just kind of did something a little different today. Today I wanted to kind of talk about some of my experiences with dating in Atlanta and how I feel about it and everything like that. Now, if you're not new to my channel, then you already know over here either we light it up or we drink some wine. So go ahead, get you some party favorites, get you some wine, get you whatever you need to do to relax and listen to this crazy story time.
Yes.
So today's another get ready with me slash story time, you know what I'm saying? I'm gonna put the makeup look that I'm going for on the screen, either here or over there, I don't know yet, y'all. And let me actually find the makeup look I wanna go for today so I can put it on the screen. So this story time is going to be about the time I went on a date with this guy and he turned out to be a swinger. I don't know if I want to do like a get ready with me chit chat, do like a chit chat get ready with me, or I don't know, y'all. I could tell story time, but I honestly might do both. Dating in Atlanta has been a whirlwind for me. Like, all these dudes are kind of like running away from some type of like weird inner issue. There's just so much going on. And then like, as you become a woman, I feel like it's so much harder for you to like differentiate. Like, what traits do you want in a man? Like, what? As I get older, I'm starting to like redefine all of those things. What it is that I want in a man, what it is that I'm attracted to, you know what I'm saying? And I found myself recently having to kind of like leave somebody that I actually deeply care about. And that's something that I feel like that's an underrated skill that not a lot of women have, is, you know, leaving a man when you love him and having that skill, because sometimes it's very much necessary. Sometimes you do develop feelings for people that are not necessarily good for you, or they don't really share the same values as you. And for these reasons, you might have to say goodbye and it might hurt, or whatever the case may be. But it's such an underrated skill that we just don't talk about as women. But anyway, I think I want to tell you guys like a story time. This is one that's kind of like lighthearted, funny. To me, at least, I think it's funny. Do y'all have y'all joints? Are y'all blunts ready? Like, are y'all wine? Like, what y'all got going on? Comment down below, let me know. In Atlanta, there's so many people that claim to be one thing, you know, they really have emotion and something, you know what I'm saying? So you'll go on a date with somebody and honestly not even know what to really expect. This story happened at least 2 years ago, yo. I think it has to be 2 years ago. My life was completely different back then. I was living, actually no, it was either 2 or 3 years ago, but I was living with those girls that were in a cult. If you're not familiar with that story, check out my roommates in a cult video. But I was living with those girls and I had a job. I was a waitress. I was actually a host, actually. You know, it was a cool little job or whatever. Actually, it wasn't a cool job. I don't even know why I just lied to y'all. It was okay, but I got some story times for that job, but that's a whole nother story. Y'all, I got a new makeup palette. I got all sorts of crazy colors, so now I can do like cute little looks. So bringing back a reoccurring character, my friend Bambi. This time it was her birthday. I don't remember how old she was turning, but I do remember that we was turned up. Like, if I still have the memories on my phone, I'm gonna insert the pictures that we took that night. But yeah, it was my girl Bambi's birthday. So we decide that we wanna go to Escobar, right? So there's two different locations in Atlanta. And Escobar, if you don't know, it's 2 Chainz restaurant. And like during the day, it's kind of like really nice and like, you know, chill little restaurant. But at night, it turns into like a full-blown club. I think we actually went to like a couple different spots that night. So I don't know, but Escobar was like number one on the list. So we started off going to her apartment. You know, we pre-gamed at her apartment. You know, we start drinking a little bit. We start partying. We start, you know, taking videos while we get ready. I'm gonna insert all our pictures because I still have the pictures on my phone, or my old phone at least. Shit's messy, I know. At the time, she had a girlfriend. And she told me that her girlfriend was gonna drive us to Escobar because it wasn't far from where we lived. So she probably lived like a 10-minute drive away from me, and then we both lived probably like a short ride away to Escobar. So after getting ready at her house and pre-gaming and stuff, as she said, you know, her girlfriend came. I met her girlfriend for the first time, and she, you know, she took us to Escobar. So it's nighttime. Escobar's jumping, you know what I'm saying? She says goodbye to her girlfriend. She gives her a little kiss or whatever. I'm getting out the car. I'm like, ew, you know, get a room. You know what I'm saying? I'm hating or whatever. So I get out the car and I'm just on some, like, you know, I'm feeling good. I got a sexy, you know, black cutout dress. I'm feeling good. You know what I'm saying? I got my bad bitch friend with me. I'm like, yes, it's my bitch birthday. Like, I'm determined to make sure this girl has the best birthday with me, because I'm like, this is my friend. Like, we're about to have a good old time. So the way that her girlfriend dropped us off, she couldn't really park on the exact, like, she couldn't really drop us off right in front of the restaurant because there was, you know, other stuff going on the street. So we have to, like, walk closer to the restaurant. So as we get out the car, whatever, I'm, like, walking around like I own this shit. Because mind you, this is not far from my house, so I know where I'm at, you know what I'm saying? I know exactly where I'm at. I've been to Escobar plenty of times. So I know where I'm going. So I'm, you know, like, come on, girl. You know, I'm walking. I'm strutting with my heels. I'm like, yeah, let's walk. So I guess this guy notices us walking across the street or whatever. And I think something was going on where there was a car crossing and it was stopping for us. So I think I was, like, confidently walking across the street. I was like, come on. Like, you know, I'm just strutting across the street. And this guy sees me, this older guy. And he's with his other older guy friend. And there's, like, two older guys. One is, like, light skin. One is, like, a darker brown skin. And the light skin guy is like, oh, I like her. Like, oh, I want her. Like, talking about me. So mind y'all, I'm tipsy. And honestly, I'm just a bold person in general. Like, especially when I got a drink in my system. Like, especially. So I think I had said something like, I think I was just walking across the street and he had grabbed my hand. I think I was like, don't touch me or something like that. And then he said something like, oh, you feisty. Like, I want you. Like, be my wife. Like, what's up with you? Like, he had said something like, I'm you my wifey or something like that. And I think I got an attitude and I was like, whatever. And then, like, my friend is laughing and it's just like a whole bunch, mind you, we walking across the street, so it's like a whole bunch of stuff going on. It's like chaotic as fuck. Me thinking I'm tough and me thinking that I'm scaring him off, he's only getting, you know, more attracted to me the more I'm, like, basically giving him attitude. So basically, it's the middle of the street and it's cars trying to pass and this guy's holding my hand and I'm basically trying to tell him to get off of me. My friend's awkwardly laughing because she really wants to get in the club. Mind you, it's a line, so we're trying to get in the line and I'm basically like, get off of me. So he's like, no, like, give me a number. So I just give him my number because it's just like, all right, like, get on my face type of shit. And Bambi was really laughing because we had just had a conversation about that. She was basically trying to tell me, like, when we go out, just don't make eye contact with men, because they be thinking that you think that you being big and bold and big and bad, but they think that that's cute because you got a cute face, so they think that you just being funny. Like, she basically was trying to tell me, like, so basically she was laughing because of that. I'm trying to put the blue in here. I want that blue to be real pigmented so they can see it. I think I'm gonna do it a couple more times. Clean the eyes up later, but let's just get to the face. Now, mind you, when I saw this guy, you know, at first, he really, like, okay, let me try to describe him. Like, he looked like LL Cool J, like an older, like, he looked like LL Cool J today. Like I don't know, like, it was given a mix of LL Cool J, Ice Cube, and the guy for Power. So when I gave him my number, it was given to him almost as if, like, for, like, a hair, like, huh, like, get out my face, like, get out my face type of shit. And I could have gave him a fake number, but he seemed like the type of guy who was gonna call me right after. Like, that's, I just didn't really want to take no chances. I was like, you know, I could just give him my number and block him. I could either block him or, you know, just ignore his messages. You know, because he was an old head. He looked maybe like 45, 50-ish. Like, I just wasn't really sweating it. You know what I'm saying? And, you know, black don't crack. So, I don't know. You'll see somebody that look like they're young, and they tell you that they're 45.
Howdy, shawty.
40?
Yeah.
But this guy, you know, he looked like he could be somebody's daddy. Like, and it wasn't even like he was ugly or anything. It just wasn't really given. Like, he was my type. So, I was just, you know, I just didn't really expect to ever see him again, to be honest. So now me and Bambi, you know, we in Escobar, you know, we get some food, you know, we dancing and we partying or whatever. So I think we went to another place anyway. And you know, that was the end of that night. Like we had some fun or whatever. I ended up at her house and we got so drunk that I spent the night at her house. I wasn't even supposed to do that. Like she didn't even know. Like the next morning I walked into her room. She was like, I thought you went home. And I was like, no girl, I passed out on your living room floor. And she was like, oh my God. And then I went home the next morning. Mind y'all, at the time I'm kind of talking to somebody. I'm still single, but you know what I'm saying? That does play a tiny role in this. So this guy would text me here and there and I would always ignore it. And he would just be saying, you know, stuff that old heads be saying. Like, you know how sometimes old heads be thinking that they really about to get a young girl. They be thinking that they be so smooth and they be saying the most random, ridiculous things. So the situation I was in, it wasn't a relationship, you know what I'm saying? So I was like, you know what? I'm young, I can date. One day I was really mad because my job was stressful, whatever the case may be. And for some reason he had mentioned a place that was by my job. And so right when I was about to get off, he, you know, he texted me and he was like, oh yeah, blase blase, you know, trying to spit game or whatever. And he, you know, he offered to take me out. And so I told him, I said, you know what, actually I work over there. So you know what, how about you, you know, take me out, whatever the case may be. And cool. I think he mentioned like, let's grab like a bite to eat and a drink. And I think I was like, you know what? That sounds perfect. I was stressed out about like my job, the person I was dating. I was like, you know what? Yeah, like let's just go out, whatever the case may be. What's the worst that can happen? You know, at the least I can do is run his pockets up. I'm having a bad day. Like what else is pretty privileged good for? You know what I'm saying? So I think I brought a change of clothes that to work or something like that. And I had a change of clothes with me. So I changed or whatever the case may be. He picked me up and like I kind of walked down farther from my job. I didn't want him to know exactly where I worked, so I told him like the area that I worked in, and then I like walked down. I said, you meet me over here. He ended up picking me up or whatever. And somehow this guy has like bottles, this like man has like bottles of alcohol. He's like, oh yeah, you want to drink with me real quick? And I'm like, I guess. And I'm like, okay. I think he bent down to tie my shoes. Like it was just a whole lot going on. Mind you, this is my first time seeing him since that one time. I was a little tipsy. So this is my first time like seeing him. And I'm like, this is somebody's daddy. Like, whose dad is it? Whose dad is this? Like, for real, like somebody get their dad trying to get a young hot tenderoni like me. Like, I don't think so, honey. So I remember him having like a bottle in his car. I don't even know. I took a video of it because he like went to his trunk. He had a bunch of different bottles in his trunk. And I told him, I'm like, you know, I'm not really comfortable drinking that because you could have done anything to these bottles. And he was like, no, look, like they brand new, like some of them still have plastic, I guess, on the bottle cap. I don't know, he was trying to show me like it's brand new, whatever. So he went to go to the restaurant to like put the reservations in, and I sat in the car and I took a video. And I was like, because I think he gave me some Smirnoff vodka, he gave me some type of white alcohol and it was nasty. I took a video or whatever. You know how you went to other boo to see that you out with another person, so you like take a little video whatever, but you being low-key whatever. That's what I was doing. I took a little video just to be, you know, controversial. But it wasn't even till I was doing anything. It was one of those things where it was like I was just kind of posting that I was in a car to get some alcohol. So I'm thinking to myself like, oh Lord, what did I get myself into and agree to this date with this man? All right. I almost felt like seeing him sober was completely different vibe. Like I was honestly just like, all right, I'm just here for the drinks and the food. Like, and I hope this man, just I hope he just respects me and just, you know, whatever the case may be, right? So the restaurant he picked was not that far from my job. It was actually like walking distance, and I had walked past this place all the time. It had like an open bar. Well, it had like an open patio, whatever the case may be. And I knew it was always popping, like no matter what time it was. Like it was always popping, even when my job was closed and, you know, I had the night shift. You know, I would always walk past this restaurant and it was always lit and popping. So he tells me that he wants to go to that spot. So I'm like, okay, cool. Like, it's a new experience. So yeah, we pull up to the little restaurant or whatever. I'm looking good. I'm looking fine or whatever. And he's looking at me like he must eat me alive. Like, he like, yeah, like he doing all of that. Like, I'm exaggerating. But you know, he was really looking mad thirsty. I'm not gonna lie. Oh, sorry, y'all. One of my friends just texted me. And then I also put on this little, so I can get this out the way. don't gotta do no put no makeup on it. But anyway, oh yeah, so we pull up to the restaurant or whatever the case may be. I remember the ambiance being real nice, you know what I'm saying? We got to seat ourselves, so we sat outside, and you know, it was nighttime, so you know, mind you, I had already taken a shot in the car or whatever. He's like, yeah, you know, he's real nice. He's like, yeah, like, I'm so glad you, you know, sat down with me. I you know, he's just popping that big shit, you know what I'm saying? So whole time I'm on a date with this man, I'm thinking about my sneaky link. I'm like, oh gosh, what am I doing here? Out here with somebody, daddy, goodness gracious. So he asked me what I want, you know what I'm saying? The waitress comes to the table, whatever, takes our order. I'm like, I didn't really know what to drink back then, because y'all, I was freshly 21, or I was either 21 or freshly 22. I just wasn't drinking that long, so I didn't really know exactly what I wanted to drink. So I ended up getting like a lemon drop or something like that, and he had requested, you know, a few other drinks that I tried. So, you know, he was cool in that department. But y'all, tell me why. So I'm sitting there on a date with this man, and he's telling me like about how... Now, mind you, this wasn't the first time I heard about this, but it was the first time that somebody like confirmed it. You know what I'm saying? Because I thought this was just like an Atlanta myth. Like, I thought it was like a myth that this was going on in Atlanta. Like, I didn't know this was for real, for real. So he keeps trying to make the conversation like kind of like lustful, you know what I'm saying? And things like that.
Would you say that you are kinky?
I'm trying to go back at the makeup picture and see what type of blush she had, though. I'm gonna use a little bit of these colors. Like I said, y'all, he keeps trying to direct the conversation back to lust. And he's basically trying to say like, oh, like, what's the nastiest thing you've done? Like, we're just, you know, and I'm entertaining it because I know good and darn well that I'm never going to see this man ever again in my life. Like, this is somebody's daddy. Like, I have no business talking to this man right now. I was young. I was even, mind you, this is 3 years ago, so I was even younger than I am now. And so I was just like, But, you know, I'm entertaining it. I'm like, yeah, buzz about it. He's like, oh, what's your fantasies? I'm like, you know, he keeps ordering more lemon drops for me. So I'm just, you know, I'm just telling him. And I'm keeping it classy, you know. I'm just sitting there, like, every time he makes a joke that's suggestive, I just kind of laugh and, like, I don't really entertain it. I just kind of like laugh, and then I like don't really engage, and then he changes the subject back to something like maybe something calmer, and then he'll try to amp it up once the food comes. Like, you know, it's just like a back and forth game and him just getting drunk. He's basically just, you know, showing his ass on this date right now. So I don't know what it was about me that made this man want to open up to me and tell me his, you know, that what he's into, whatever. But he starts telling me that, you know, there's this underground place he goes to, and shop. Oh, can I say that on YouTube? It's this underground place he used to go to, and basically it was like a swingers thing. Like, when it was his turn to tell me the craziest thing he's done, he was like, yeah, like one time, you know, I was dating this girl and she brought me to this place, and ever since then I've been going like all the time, insinuating that he participates in swinging. Like, he goes there with a girl and he ends up partaking in activities with various other people. And he's telling me like, yeah, it's fun. Like, the first time I went, I really wasn't into it. So I'm like, cause I'm engaging in a conversation with him. I'm like, really? Like, and what did you think? He's like, well, when I first went there, you know, I didn't really like it. Like, I thought it was weird. I didn't even touch anybody. I just watched. The second time I actually didn't get, and I'm just looking at this man like, you know, I'm eating my food, you know what I'm saying? I'm just like, oh my gosh, like, this is crazy. So I guess because I'm actually curious to see what he's talking about, and I'm like asking him questions, he's now getting more comfortable to express more things with me. And out of nowhere, y'all, he goes, yeah, you got a nice body, yeah. You like this? And then he flips his phone. He like turns his phone under the table, and then like it was his meat, y'all. Like, his Vienna sausage, it was his meat. And it wasn't a Vienna, it was, you know, he had something on him. And I was just thinking to myself, why me?
Oh, no.
Are you serious?
Not what it looks
right
like.
In front of my salad? Like, why did you choose me? Like, why did you choose me? Of all people, you know, and I don't know, like, I understand, like, when a guy comes to you on the street And when you choose to entertain, that is your fault. You know what I'm saying? Because he could be anybody. But it's just, you know, I can never get the normal ones. And if that wasn't enough, like when he showed it to me, I was just kind of like, oh wow. He was like, yeah. And then he was like, yeah, this is what I could, this is, you know, one of my girls that I've been going with. He swipes over and he basically like took a picture of this girl in his bed. But the way he was like describing it, he was like, oh yeah, and this is like one of my homes where I would bring you to if you wanted to come back with me. And then he swipes and it's like a picture of a girl in the bed. And like, he had just got done like doing stuff for her, I guess. And she had like a BBL. And I was just like, why are you showing me this girl's bare body? Like, is this legal? Like, this cannot be for real. Like, are you for real? You for fake? No, you for real?
You cannot be for real. Oh my God, you for real? No, you for fake? No, you for real?
Kind of cute. And clean it up a little though. Okay. His eye makeup look is like very soft. Cotton candy kind of. Now, I don't know exactly what look I want to do for my hair. All right, so let's finish the story. So y'all, after he shows me like a baddie laying in his bed after he done wiped her out, apparently, I was just like he was basically asking me like if I wanted to join him on these festivities, if I wanted to go to one of these parties with him. I was like, no, it's okay. And I was like, actually, you know, I got class tomorrow, you know, because I'm young or whatever. Can you take me home? Y'all, he took me home. Tell me why, after, like, why were you, like, finishing eating the food or whatever? He was like, by the way, I have this daughter, and me and my daughter, you know, we have a company together, whatever the case may be. We make soap. And then he gave me a bar of soap. Like, he gave me a bunch of different bars of soap, y'all, because they had basically handmade some soap. And I'm not going to lie, the soap did smell good. But I'm just thinking to myself, like, because mind you, it's like 2 o'clock in the morning. Because he had me out there late, y'all. He had me out late all types of hours of the night. And so he drops me back home. He's like, oh, I'm so glad, like, you went out. And he gave me the little business card for him and his daughter. And I was like, this was a, you're an interesting one, okay? This was an interesting night. But yeah, you know what I mean? Like, you just never know who you're going to run into when you come to Atlanta. Like, the men here, they say they into one thing, they be into something completely different. I remember one time I was dating a guy, he told me that if I dated him, I would have to use a safe word in a bed. I said, a safe word? What you be doing? I don't know if I'm ready for all that right now. But yeah, y'all, this is the finished look. I hope you guys like it. Let me know if you guys actually want a video of me talking about, you know, how my actual dating experiences have been in Atlanta, you know, what I've learned so far. Let me know if you guys will be interested in like a chit chat, get ready with me, you know, a little insight on my life and what I'm going through and how I feel, you know what I'm saying? It's eclipse season, y'all, be careful. It's about to be an eclipse or whatever the case may be. So please just, you know, keep your head on straight, you know what I'm saying? And stick to your standards as best as you can, okay? And I probably should put a hot comb to this wig. I want to fix the part a little bit. But yes, y'all, for right now, this is the finished look. Let me know if you guys like it or the case may be. I got this hair from a company called Caitlin Hair. You know, they sent me this beautiful wig. And I may or may not upload my video on how I got this beautiful ombre color. I dyed it kind of like dark into the highlight color. But I'm probably going to dye the hair completely black today. So, yeah. I'm so glad that you guys came to watch this video. And if you got this far, give me a like, comment, and subscribe, honey, because it would mean the world to me. It really would, I promise. And yeah, without further ado, I'll see you in my next one. Bye.